Awake. Awake, ye slow-moving jumble of filth. Bear witness to the clawed-in memorials to one Mr. Mac Daddy and his good friend, Gus. I stop to pore over the thimble in my brain and its many curvatures examined by my mind fingers. The telegram beeps a big one and flashes back sunshine bright. Yes, seems the news is true. I have definitely soiled myself. I feel naked in the eye of these common trollops, busying themselves with mouthy move and looky eye blink blink. I wonder if they notice the beautiful and intoxicating smell permeating through their nostrils. It is a brand I call my own, and I call it that from the heavens above, with great eyes like a werewolf. And I yell and I scream and I pee like one too, and I bing and I bong and I sing a good song. But god damn it, do I love the universe. Do I love various films with action superheroes and coffee flavored ice cream, things like pinches on a good chunk of skin, a nice fold of skin. Commercials are wonderful as well. Cricket, what a neat name for a sport. Suddenly I was jerked quite compunctuously as I noticed a she, who was not a he, but was rather a being, a person. It was quite strange. She was not previously on this ship of foods. Too early for a sunlit jaunt, I postured. She took one enraptured glance and turned her head towards the glass with a balled up piece of cloth at her nose. Oh, I said, finally someone who gets me. It was at that point I cemented our kinship by letting my body dissolve into a great pool. What vibrant beauty, so overwhelming was the sight, that everyone got off at the next stop to cry tears of joy and compose deeply sensitive poetry. Twixt the fiber of a man's soul runs a mighty stream. It's the night show.
Put your weed in there.
Calm down.
I'm calm! Oh.
Oh. Oh. No, that's not it.
But I want my own ass! I want my own ass!
I know.
Of you to invite your friends and the bus driver and the police force to our daughter's dance recital?
Huge ballet fan. All of them.
It's like, ew. I just got a little nauseous there touching them. That's funny.
Oh, you want a bite?
No. Feeling them's enough. I'll do that again.
No. I meant food. Are you hungry?
Oh!
Hey, Malcolm, I didn't know you worked at Kmart. And apparently the hair on top of your head didn't know it either.
What?
Do me a favor, go like this. I think I got something in my teeth.
What? No, it's a fun time for the kids to be together and they can do kids things. And come on. Go share it. Share the master bedroom.
That's Hawaiian fun.
That's three.
Take him out to the hallway.
Yeah, high five is right, buddy. I knew you were gonna burp, but the vomit thing was awesome. That's what she gets for eating my roast beef sandwich. Willie, did you see that?
Yeah, that was crazy. Personal masseuse?
Oh, I pull really hard. Watch your mother. She's gonna have relief. Mm-hmm. What happened? She's sleeping with him?
Knockout.
Hello and welcome.
My name is Jeff Laserbeam. Ever since I got out of Harvard-Yale College with an A-plus degree in computer, I've been trying to find my place in the universe. I've gotten offers from Google, Friendbook, and that nice corner office on Wall Street that Medida always wanted for me. But I have a secret. My real passion in life has always been hacking into cyberweb. Ever since I was a youngling, I've been drawn onto the crack of fingers on the keyboard. When I was 8, I won award for most emails. I've been to all the internet websites at least twice. Even the secret government ones. I just hope my secret never gets out.
I'm coming! Send. Yes?
Are you Jeff Laserbeam?
Yes.
I'm from the government. Your hacking's got you in a lot of trouble.
No.
Yes, but you're such an expert hacker. If you hack for us, I won't turn you over to the cyber police.
Not the cyber police. I thought you guys were best in hacking business.
All right, we may be the best, but sometimes the best isn't good enough. That's why we need you. We need you to help hack into the terrorist mainframe.
I gave up that life many years ago. Ever since I fell in love with my beautiful wife, Pamela, I've been focusing exclusively on our love making.
This Pamela?
No! But Pamela!
Sorry, Jeff. We tried to stop the rogue computers, but she super spazzed and got deadified.
Computers? But I just made her dinner. And I loved her! My heart, it does not compute.
So is that a yes?
I am just one man. How could that possibly make a difference?
It's not just you, Jeff. We got you a whole team of cool hacker nerds just like you. There's the tall one. We'll get into that later. But if you stay until the end of season and we don't get cut off during sweeps, you might get boned by the hot one. Double nuts.
Yeah!
Hey Dish TV subscribers, my name is Summer Shandy, and sometimes I can be a bitter lemon, but most of the time I just like to have fun. So if you like calling and partaking with me, I'd be so down. And got some girlfriends here too, you know, just chatting, max and relax and kind. Oh hey. What's up, Desire?
Hi, I'm Desire, and my parents died in an accident.
So sad.
Yeah, now I have all the time in the world to spend on your phone calls.
I love laughing with you. You're hysterical.
We can talk about anything.
Yeah.
The weather.
What's that, baby? You want to talk about your VHS collection? Well, I'm here to listen.
I'm not 18, but I am at my peak fertility.
Or we can just have fun with each other like girlfriends. Just casually playing. Do whatever scenarios you want. You wanna play? Come to mama. It's okay. I'll talk to you no matter how disgusting you are. Why don't we chat by the fire?
Hello, DirecTV subscribers. It's Eddie Vedder here. We've got a serious conversation. Let's talk about Flomax. Before Flomax, I was going to the toilet 40 times a day, but only pissing one time a day. There's a better way. It's the Flomax way. If your flow is irregular or too regular, but you don't urinate enough, call Flomax and ask for the Eddie discount. We'll get your flow back to even, and we'll even give you a free CD copy of my solo album for Into the Wild. Thanks to Flomax, I have the freedom I need and the quality of life I deserve. I'm ready to begin my life again.
Time to call that phone sex hotline I heard about earlier. Ordering DirecTV was an awesome choice, all right.
Hello?
Oh. Hi.
Hey, cowboy. I'm Desire.
Desire?
Yeah.
Desire, you sound fucking hot.
Sorry. Yeah. I told that.
Yeah, okay. This is what I want you to do for me, Desire. You can do whatever I want.
Oh yeah, you know.
Do whatever I want.
All right. You know, baby.
I want you to recite the alphabet up to and no more than the letter K. Get to K for me, baby.
Ooh, baby, that's real freaky.
Yeah.
I better start with a nice A.
Ooh.
And then I follow up with a little B.
Ooh.
bring it over.
Oh, where's
to
it gonna go? Where's it gonna go?
C.
Oh, it always goes to C from there. Yeah.
But wait a minute. I feel like getting real hard with a nice D.
Oh no. Oh no.
If you want, I think I'll gonna bring it over to the E.
Oh no. Okay. For me.
Oh yeah.
Quack like a goose for me. Oh, you're such a goose. Oh, you're a dirty goose.
Oh, I'm gonna migrate for the winter.
Oh, you're
not
a dirty goose.
Coming.
Oh, you're the dirty goose in the gaggle, aren't you?
I am. Oh, I'm gonna shit on your lawn.
Daddy goose. Daddy goose didn't give you enough attention.
No.
A little gander.
She was a little frisky Canadian.
Didn't take you under his wing.
Gone to knowing that little woman for 3 years. She has a child, but the child is just so annoying. You know, the child's getting in the middle of our relationship. You know what I mean? The child thinks the world revolves around him, and it makes me mad. You know what I mean? I'm trying to watch the football game, and he wants to watch SpongeBob. You know, I want to have sex with his mother, but no, he wants to come with his mother. You know, it gets annoying. I get mad. I do not get violent, but it's to the point where it's got to stop. You know what I mean? And I don't know what to do. She won't listen to me. She won't listen. I try to talk to her. She goes, oh, it's my son. I go, I don't care. What about me? Why don't you care about my feelings? Yeah. I want to be happy. I want to get laid.
One of the things that that we need to recognize is there are three basic reasons why individuals become angry. And one is...
Welcome, kids. This episode, as always, is brought to you by Aquafresh.
Wow. Did you use my tape toothpaste?
That's right, I did.
Oh, that's good.
Aquafresh, extreme clean whitening action. If you want a real whitening action, you're going to look to the people in the FBI.
You want nudity?
Do you guys want nudity?
Of course I want nudity.
Do you want a dick in it?
Thought you'd never ask. President Obama. President Obama. Obama. You know, if you put the words Obama and Mamabo together, you'd get most of the letters that make up Obama, but twice?
No, I didn't realize that.
Now, you know, it's all started with Common Core. You know, you have people that are working as teachers. They call themselves teachers, but they're not really teachers. They're more like indoctrinators in chief. They take people that walk over to places like the subway, places like restaurants, places like Burger King. You know, they take those kinds of people and they put them down. They put them in these little neat rows of people. They sit them. Some people, they call them lunch counters. I call them tombs, all right? I call them boxes. I call them FEMA camps, all right? I take people and you take them down to the store, all right? And you buy them things like cereal. You buy cornbread. You buy things that are made in factories. And when you get people in factories, you take other people's lives. You take other people's lives and you take them away. They're gone. They're gone. They're not even there anymore. You know that? Do you know that? That's what this country is becoming. You know, I got a degree, alright? I got a degree. I've got a piece of paper. It says my name on it. It says something in Latin. And I got it, alright? You know what I did with it? I put it in my fucking fridge. I fucking put it there, and I let it sit, and I let it acclimate, and I let it use to the cold environment that it's going to bring to me. It's going to bring me and my ilk and my elks, my farm with elks. It's going to freeze us to death.
I'm Sarah McLaughlin. Will you be an angel for a helpless animal? Every day, innocent animals are abused, beaten, and neglected. And they're crying out for help. Please, call the number on your screen with a monthly gift right now. For just $18 a month, only 60 cents a day, you'll help rescue animals from their abusers and provide medical care, food, shelter, and love. Call or join online in the next 30 minutes and you'll receive this welcome kit with the photo of an animal in the shelter right now. One who's been given a second chance, thanks to you.
All right, kids who are watching this ad anywhere on the internet, please turn off ad block. Tell Uncle Eddie is able to afford Flomax these days. I don't really have any other choice. I'm eating cheese crackers and Lunchables most of the time. But I need Flomax for my I piss far too often. My stepfather was a huge dick. He didn't let me watch DirecTV. I occasionally spoke to Kurt Cobain on the phone. I put an avocado on an album cover. It's embarrassing, but Eddie's gotta live.
Look for Eddie live and unplugged this Saturday at Mohegan Sun Casino.
Pushkin, Gogol, Vanya Ymir, that's a War and Peace. Oh.
Vanya Ymir?
Siva. Vanya Ymir.
Vanya Ymir.
It's a молодой Pushkin. Mikhailovskaya, Linovaya, Alaya. Oh, interesting.
You drinking a beer?
Mm-hmm. Where's my beer?
Is that your cousin's beer?
You know, I learned that the real, like, porn connoisseurs use Bing, not Google.
Why is that?
Bing just has more accurate and detailed search results. You know, if you're putting in something obscure, like, you know, Swedish POV or something, you know, you want to get a good algorithm to get you the videos that you want to see. You know, not like, it's a Swedish picnic, you know, it's a point of view of a picnic. Like, no, I want to see some boobies on a train, perhaps. Maybe a bus. Swede plus POV plus mass transport. Hashtag island style.
film, and we're gonna do it. I'm doing this for the fans that I know around the globe that love real talk. Hell, I wasn't. Wait a minute, calm down. I was at a club with who? Get the fuck. Man, you know what? Girl, I'm not about to sit up here and argue with you about who's to blame or call no names. Real talk, see girl. Only thing I'm trying to establish with you is not who's right or who's wrong, but what's right and what's wrong. Real talk. Just because your friend says she saw me at a club with some other bitches sitting in VIP, smoking and drinking and kicking it. Tell me, girl, did she say there were other guys there? Did she say there were other guys there? Were there other guys there? Well, tell me this. How the fuck she know I was with them other girls then? When the whole club packed, wait a minute, let me finish what I've got to say. I've been with you 5 years and you listening to your motherfucking girlfriends. I don't know why you fuck with them old jealous, no man having assholes anyway. Real talk, always accusing me of some old bullshit when I'm just trying to have a good time. Robert, you did this, Kills, I heard you did that. Don't you think I got enough bullshit on my mind? Real talk, hold up. Didn't I just give you money to go get your hair, toes, and nails done other day? Yeah, your ass was smiling then. Real talk. Gave who some damn money? I ain't gave nobody no damn money, girl. Is you tweaking? You see what your problem is? You're always running off at the mouth, 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 telling your girl your motherfucking business when they don't.